please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Well, obviously, the stock we're not talking about, it's not a mid-cap, you know, if you're talking about ITC, but the stock that we're talking about is ITH. That's International Travel House. Why are we talking about this particular company? Well, it's a small 160 crore company, market cap company. But the reason why we're talking about ITC and this company is because ITC is the promoter. It has nearly around 61% stake in this listed company. That's International Travel House. Now, if you're looking at this company, you'll say, what does it do? Well, it's into travel. So it's playing that tourism theme, really. And in fact, it's into various business development. They're into car rentals, foreign exchange, as well as MIC. That's meetings, incentives, conferences, as well as exhibitions. But you'd say, what else does the company do? Well, they have a couple of global tie-ups as well, and they are approved by IATA, as well as Department of Tourism. That's by the Government of India. And internationally, they have a couple of these global tie-ups as well. Notably, in their presentation and in their annual report of last year, they mentioned Global Star Travel Management. But moving on then, and if you just take a look at this company, and you'll be looking at it very, very closely, you'll see who are their clients. Well, a whole host of clients were mentioned in the annual report. I picked up a couple of them, and this is what is mentioned in 2017 annual report. But we're looking at various numbers and various financials for the company then. So if you pull up the next slide, then you'll say the market capitalization is around 160 crores. They have a decent cash balance, close to around 40 crores. It's into various mutual funds and liquid investments. So close to around 20-25% of the market cap is protected by cash in its books. If you look at the net worth of the company, well, it's almost as much as the market capitalization. So trading at around one time price to book. Moving on, then you'll ask, what about the dividend? They've been paying dividend consistently of around 4.25 rupees for the last many quarters, though the EPS growth hasn't really caught up. In fact, the EPS growth has been declining from around, roughly around, you know, at one point of time, they used to do a net profit of around 15 to around 20 crores. Now that number has come down sharply lower, but the dividend payout has, you know, is at around 4.25 rupees. That's telling you that the dividend payout ratio has gone up in spite of the financials not looking very, very good. You'll pull up, you know, the last quarter's results, and that's why, in fact, the company did come on my radar. Fourth quarter looked good. You know, it looked better on a small base, but the last few years, they've not done much. Revenues, 180 crores to around 210 crores over the last 4 to around 5 years. The margins, at one point of time, they used to do margins in excess of around 15 to around 20%. Now, that's come down lower. You just pull up the last few years of the revenue chart. 180 to around 210 crores is what they were doing. In the past year, the margins had come down drastically. So that's the revenue number we're talking about. The margin number as well should come up for you on the screen. That's seen a bit of a decline. And obviously, poor operational performance will tell you that the net profit as well hasn't grown much. So the net profit number as well should come up for you on the screen. Last quarter, only around 7 crores. So 160 crore market capitalization company doing only 7 crores of net profit. Not very, very good for all the talk and hype and being in a sector that's really in tourism. Well, what are the key negatives? We have such a strong promoter. You're not given any growth in the last few years. You know, the receivable days, you're doing sales of around 200 crores, receivables of around 110 crores or thereabouts. So receivable days will be nearly around 6 months. And finally, the ROE, ROCE, and they have cash in their books. So I've even calculated the ROIC, all of them in single digits. So good parentage, you have good dividend payout, cash in the books. But interesting to see, can the business grow from here? Can we see better margins going ahead?
Okay, Nigel, thanks a lot for that. Standard disclaimer, not a stock recommendation, just